We all know that learning is a process, not a product. Learning involves many steps. It is a process of interacting with the environment to give the right responses. The environment gives us several stimuli, and we learn how to respond to them. And this involves several steps. We will learn what are those steps which are involved in the process of learning. Let us understand which are the steps which are involved in the process of learning. Motivation, which is the prerequisite, then setting up a goal, exploring the situation, perceiving that situation, responding to the stimuli which come from that situation, reinforcement which is needed, and then integration of behaviors. This is the process of learning. At the end of the session, you will be able to explain this process of learning and able to explain the different steps which are involved in this process. Learning involves many things to keep us going towards the reaching of the goal. We call them as prerequisites of learning. And among these are the maturation, which comes first, without which we cannot learn. It brings in the readiness for learning. At the same time, it sets the limits for learning. The genetic constraints will always be there. Heredity decides how much we learn, and the environment also gives us opportunities to learn. Maturation being an important factor, the natural growth and development decides at what age we should learn what. So one should be mature enough in order to be ready to learn a particular thing when we'll be happily learning those things. Second is motivation, which will not let our efforts stop in between and make us reach the goal. And in order to be motivated, we always need someone to show us where we are going, applaud, cheer us, or even say a word of praise or appreciation, which will show how we are doing, and that will energize us and keep us going. This is very much necessary for motivation. And the third thing in that is interest. Without interest, nothing can be achieved. And interest and attention are two sides of the same coin. So once we are attentive, we will develop the interest. Therefore, learning to be attentive, to focus on something which we are perceiving, is very important in order to learn. So the prerequisites of learning are maturation, motivation, and interest. Now let us understand each step involved in this process of learning. When we are motivated and we have set up the goal, we explore the situation which is in front of us, we perceive it, we make meaning of that situation, accordingly we respond, give a response. Reinforcement helps us to learn it properly, and then we integrate several responses in order to reach the goal. Now let us understand again, delving for some time on motivation. What is this motivation? Why is it some students burn midnight oil just before the exams? Why is it a child, even after falling down from the cycle, keeps on learning it again and again? Because they have their drive or a motive or a need to do that particular action. So that is so strong that will not tire you. So energy is that driving force, energizing force, which directs, sustains, and controls our behavior towards the achievement of our goal. Motivation is very much necessary, as though we may be mature, unless there is that desire, the driving force to learn, we will not be motivated to learn. When we are not motivated, no interest is generated, and because of which our focus will not be there and will not be able to explore the situation and perceive it so as to respond to it correctly. No learning will take place unless there is that inner drive to achieve that particular goal. In order to reach that goal, we need to have that energy, and motivation is that energizing force which drives, sustains, and controls all our behavior in the direction of reaching the goal. A child may burn the midnight lamp before the exams. A boy learning cycling may not give up cycling, though he may fall several times. Why does it happen? Because in the first case, that boy who is burning the midnight oil is very keen on scoring high marks, and the boy in the cycling process wants to learn cycling and is not ready to give up. Similarly, a girl may go on practicing singing despite obstacles, despite hunger, for several hours because one wants to master that particular piece of music. All these need high level of motivation. Motivation is nothing but interest inherent in that act of achieving a behavior, where one is not fatigued, one's energy is not sapped despite hours of work, because that motivation keeps us going as it is an energizing driving force. Therefore, every learning needs motivation at its beginning. Depending on the strength of our motives, direction of learning will also depend. Now, many students come to the class. Some want to just pass with average marks. Some want to just come to the class because their parents have asked them to do so. So, the motivation level of these students is different. One student who really wants to make it to the top and takes education or learning as an investment for that will be highly motivated, and another student who is just driven or pushed by parents to learn is the one with less motivation. So the amount which is learned depends upon the strength of motivation. Higher the motivation, higher is the efforts put and higher is the learning, and vice versa. Next step in the learning process is the goal. You have to reach the goal, and the existing repertoire of behaviors is not enough to reach that goal. So now you have to acquire new behaviors which are required to cope with the present situation in order to reach the goal. For example, you BA students, if you were to get your mark sheets today, you would never even think of learning anything because you have reached your goal. But now, why you are struggling to learn? Because you need to master certain knowledge and gain certain behaviors before you can get your BA degree. Therefore, the goal is a very important one in the process of learning. The goal needs certain behaviors which are to be shown if that is to be reached. And in order to develop those behaviors, one strives to respond in different ways so as to reach the goal. Our behavior, therefore, is because of certain needs. And the needs can be the basic needs like clothing, shelter, which can satisfy the need, or they can also be higher order needs or psychosocial needs which are there in human beings, because generally we all have satisfied our basic needs and we always strive for higher and higher order needs. Now, let us look at this goal, which is in consonance with the need. A child is very thirsty. The child wants water. So, the child will be looking for water, and all his efforts would be to find out where the water is available. And once the water is available, the child quenches his thirst and satisfies his need, then that need is satisfied. Then only the child can attend to other needs. Therefore, the goal which we have in front of us becomes the prime one for us to reach that particular goal. So, for different persons, the goals will be different. Depending upon that, the level of motivation also will be different. So, we cannot make all students learn in the class with the same motivation and with the same efforts. That is because they have different goals as their priorities, though learning is also one of the goals. Having set the goal, the child is facing a particular situation and the child explores that particular situation. How does the child explore? The child interacts with the situation, gains information about that situation. We call that information as stimuli. Stimuli are those information which we receive from our sense organs. For example, a sight, a sound, a taste, a touch, or even a smell, this all can be a stimuli which we get from a particular situation. So these different stimuli register on our sense organs, but then we focus on only those stimuli which will help us to reach our goal, and we think of how to respond to those stimuli. The manner in which the individual makes meaning of that stimuli in the environment differs from person to person, and depending on that, a person will react. Let's look at this example of blind man and the elephant. These blind men are trying to perceive how an elephant is or what an elephant looks like. So they are touching the different parts of the elephant and they are coming out with their own meaning making regarding how an elephant looks. For example, a person who may just touch its trunk will say the elephant is like a pillar, while a person who may feel its tail will think that the elephant is like a rope. The person who feels the body of the elephant will say the elephant looks like a wall, and one who touches the ears will say the elephant is like a fan. Same is the situation even in a classroom or elsewhere when we are perceiving different situations. The stimuli are the same, but the interpretation or the perception becomes different. That is why, though the same teacher is teaching a class of 40 students, each student will perceive whatever is taught in a different manner, because of which their responses will be different. Therefore, the clarity regarding perception is very important, and the teacher's explanation, description with various visuals, animations is therefore very much necessary in order to give clear perception of the situation. If the information is less, the person will develop a distorted meaning of that particular situation, because of which the person will not be able to have clarity in the concepts also. The basis of concepts is perception. Percepts leads to concepts. Therefore, we should keep in mind that the perception of the situation becomes very clear, so that the responses which are given to that will be the right ones. So, perception plays a very crucial role in eliciting a particular reaction or a response. The individual will try to act in such a way so as to overcome the obstacles in that environment. What are the obstacles to reaching that goal? What are the obstacles which are being faced in that environment? It depends on the perception of the individual. If the perception is very clear, the individual knows what are the challenges and will exhibit such behavior which will overcome those barriers to reach the goal. But if the individual has not perceived it properly, he or she will exhibit such behaviors which may not help them to reach the goals. Such incorrect responses are not called learned responses, because they have not helped the individual to overcome the barriers and reach the goal. Only when we overcome the barriers and reach the goal, then we will satisfy the need. Therefore, the individual will be continuously making attempts, giving several responses in an attempt to overcome the barriers and reach the goal. Clear perception will definitely help to lessen the mistakes and make the right responses. For all these efforts, we need reinforcement. What is reinforcement? Anything that strengthens the learned responses is reinforcement. An individual learns something, is praised for that, the individual will show that response again and again. If an individual shows a response, gets punishment, is reprimanded, or that response is ignored, then the response slowly gets weakened and the individual will not practice that and strengthen that response. Therefore, reinforcement is that which strengthens a particular behavior, and that is very much necessary for learning. This reinforcement may come in the form of a praise, an appreciation, a pat on the back, rewards, or even that you are right or correct, so that the individual knows that he is heading in the correct path, and that will help to reach the goal. And the very awareness that one is heading in the right path will energize one's efforts, and the individual will make sustained attempts to reach the goal. Therefore, reinforcement is an essential part of the process of learning. One response will not help us to reach a particular goal. The goal demands that we combine several of our correct learned responses and exhibit a particular behavior which would enable us to reach the goal. So, in order to do that, we pick up different responses in different situations, and that repertoire of responses is to be integrated in the right manner to reach the goal. This can be compared to a glass of water which already has some water in it, and vacate it before adding more, and we will just add on to the water which is already there, or add some color to that in order to change its color. In the sense that we do not learn every response right from the beginning again and again. The learned responses, as we know, are already there in our repertoire, because learning is relatively permanent change in behavior, and learning is incremental in nature. Whatever previous learning is there, the new learning gets added on to that, and in this way, slowly over a period of time, we develop those requisite repertoire of behaviors which is necessary to overcome the barriers and reach the goal. These different behaviors can be picked up in different situations. For example, one can be learning certain things through computers, another may read several books and pick up certain responses. These are all the situations which are being perceived by the students, and another person may pick up certain things from nature, another person may solve some riddles. So, different kinds of situations help us to develop in us different responses which will toward the end be integrated and then used to respond to a particular situation in order to overcome the barriers. Thank you.